welcome back to my channel, and if you're new, welcome. This video will be a sewing one, but not a fashion one as I would normally do, because I live in what they call a moderate climate, but I think it's a cold climate, so I'm always cold, I'm always snuggled up in blankets and things, and I thought, well, I'll make a travel blanket, because when you go in the car now, well, not now, but in a few weeks in my country, it will be really cold, and then you have to wait till the heating turns up, and I don't have a car with seat heating, so I'm always cold, and I have some cashmere on my mouth, I think. I thought I'll make a blanket. Of course, when you have to drive yourself, you cannot put a blanket on top of you, but when you don't have to drive, you can snuggle up in a blanket. So I thought I'll make a travel blanket, but not just a blanket, because a blanket is just a piece of cloth, so you don't have to do anything unless hemming the sides, but I wanted to put it in a travel case. So I made a travel case, and it's not just a normal case, but it is a fashion, what's it called? Packing cube. And that means, I'll show you, it has two zippers, the white one and the black one in my case, because I had these colors, so don't matter what kind of color you have. But it means that the white zipper compresses it more. So normally, when you put the blanket in this case, it will be this big. And you see, this black one, you didn't see before when it was set up, and now you see it. So when you compress it, it gets closed, so your travel case will be smaller. And that's what we're gonna make. And of course, inside is the blanket. And it's a really big one, because I want to fit in totally. And it is a fleece, and the nice thing of fleece is you don't have to hem it. So you can just cut it straight, make sure you got the lines really straight. And I found this really funny fabric. I hope you can see it. It is about shoes and shoe sale, and if you know me, it is exactly me. So I thought it was such a funny fabric to use for this. It's really nice. It's my length till my chin, and on the bottom I made this pouch that you can put your feet in. And this blanket is also nice to take with you when you travel by plane, because then you can put the pouch in your travel bag. It doesn't take up much space, but you have your nice clean blanket, because I heard the blankets in the plane aren't often washed. They just put it in a new plastic sealing and then you get it and it's not washed before. So I rather have my own clean blanket. So we're gonna make this and I'll show you how to make it. This is easy, of course, the pouch also, but you just have to know how to do it. So go on to the tutorial. So we have here our 2 meters of fleece. And what we do first we cut off 35 centimeters off the bottom, because we're gonna use that for the pouch. And then you take the bottom 25 centimeters and you flip that over to the white side. So white sides together. And then we sew that down here on the side. So on the one side and also on the other side, you close up the bottom. And that is because when you flip it over, then you have nice pouch to put your feet in here. So that's what we're gonna do first. Just sew down those two parts 25 centimeters from the bottom. So for the pouch we're gonna cut a rectangle of 35 by 25 centimeters, and we're gonna cut that with rounded edges 2 times out of the fleece and 2 times out of a lining fabric, or at least a not stretchy fabric to line it, so that the pouch won't be stretchy, otherwise you cannot compress it when you have a stretchy fabric, of course. And then for that in between part that we're gonna compress it with, we make a rectangle out of 125 by 8 centimeters, and mine is on the double, so it is longer than this. So we're gonna cut that out for the pouch, and then we can sew it together with the zipper. And because this is fleece, this won't fray, so you don't have to hem the sides. If you want to, you can, but you don't need to. You can just leave it like it is. And then what you do is you flip it over to the other side so that the worm sides are together, and you have this pouch on the inside. And then you measure where the middle is of your blanket, and then in the middle also at 25 cents, but you stitch it down because that makes that this will stay up better. If you let it loose, then this will fall down all the time. So if you stitch it down in the middle, it will stay like this, and then you have a nice place to put your feet in. So now you take one fleece part and one lining part and you pin them together because we're gonna treat them now as one. So make sure they are nicely secured together. I just already sewed on my piece of fleece onto my zipper. This is the smaller zipper. And then we're gonna pin on the zipper all the way around with the fabric, all the way around this rectangle of the pouch. On this one, our zipper nicely sewn on. So now go to the other rectangle. Also pin them on top of each other, the lining and the fleece, so that they are one now. And then we take that long rectangle piece and we take our other zipper and we zip it open. And we pin it to the end, and then the open parts we sew down to the sides as quickly as you can. You can go all the way down, but you go it as quickly as you can. I need for sure, because my zipper is too short, so I hope I can manage it like this. So on a diagonal, go to the side and then you can leave it there, because then we're gonna sew it onto our other part. So I pinned down the big zipper to the other part of the rectangle, the other rectangle. And I put the in-between part on top of it. And you must see how I did this. I opened up the zipper. I sewed it on here on this part so that it goes to the outer part of that in-between part. And then here I pinned it all the way around. And then at the end I pinned this together, this back, so that we can put that over the beginning of the zipper here, because we have to close this up. I also made a loop to sew in here between when we've done the outside part of the zipper. So you pin this part underneath the top part and you pin it down, and then you sew it all the way around, and then you have your in-between part with your zipper overlapping here. So it's a very important part that you do this right, otherwise your zipper won't do what it has to do. And now you see that I have two less overlap. Unfortunately, it should have been around here, and that's exactly the 10 centimeters that I lose, but I hope it will compress enough that it will have enough for this 2 centimeters that I have left now. But if you have a longer zipper, it will be more perfectly to compress later on. I pinned on the other part of the long zipper, and make sure you leave the short zip a little bit open so that you can turn it right side out to check if you have aligned the two parts of the long zipper up right. I also closed up the zipper to see if it was looking right, that not the corners are crooked from each other or something, or that the ends of your zipper are not matching here, or the ends, and they must be matching on the same height. So make sure you check that first before you sew the second part of the long zipper down. And this is what the pouch looks like. The white zipper goes over the black one to compress it. To show you how it looks, maybe you didn't really understand what the in between part is the extra part for the compression. And it would have been even better. What I didn't have is when the white zipper was a bit longer, then you have a little bit more overlap over your black zipper that goes from here, but like it is now, it is good enough and it compresses very nicely. And then the black zipper goes from this side all the way to the other side where the white zipper goes over. So that is the compressing side. So it's a very nice way to make your pouch a little bit smaller so that it isn't that bulky in your travel bag. And it's a nice way to take your things with you without having too much stuff, without having too big of a bag, needing too big of a bag. So this was my travel bag with the pouch. So if you like this tutorial, please subscribe, please like them and share them with others. Please leave a comment if you like to, if you have something to say, something to ask, if you have a question for me, just leave a comment down below. And I'll see you again next Monday with a new tutorial. Bye!